राधा कृष्ण बोल बोल बोलो रे सुभाए, राधा कृष्ण बोल बोल बोलो रे सुभाए, राधा कृष्ण बोल बोल बोलो रे सुभाए, राधा कृष्ण बोल बोल बोलो रे सुभाए। जय शिक्षा दिया सब न दिया तिरछे नेचे गौर नेताए,
शिक्षा दिया सब न दिया तिरछे नेचे गौर नेताए,
मिटे मायार वशे जाचो देशे काचो हो बुडू गुबाए,
मायार वशे जाचो बेसे काचो हो बुडू गुबाए,
राधा कृष्णा बोल बोल बोलो रे सुभाए, राधा कृष्णा बोल बोल बोलो रे सुभाए, राधा कृष्णा बोल बोल बोलो रे सुभाए,
राधा कृष्णा बोल बोल बोलो रे सुभाए।
कृष्ण दास ये विश्वास कर ले तो आर दुख ना,
कृष्ण दास ये विश्वास कर ले तो आर दुख ना,
जी कृष्ण दास ये विश्वास कर ले तो आर दुख ना,
कृष्ण दास ये विश्वास कर ले तो आर दुख ना,
कृष्ण बोल बे जावे पुलक हावे जोर बे आंखी बोली ता,
कृष्ण बोल बे जावे पुलक हावे जोर दे आंखी बोली ता,
कृष्ण बोल बे जावे पुलक हावे जोर बे आंखी बोली ता,
कृष्ण बोल बे जावे पुलक हावे जोर बे आंखी बोली ता,
राधा कृष्ण बोल बोल बोलो रे सुभाए,
राधा कृष्ण बोल बोल बोलो रे सुभाए,
राधा कृष्ण बोला संगे चलो ये मात्र भिक्षा छाए,
राधा कृष्ण बोलो संगे चलो ये मात्र भिक्षा छाए,
जाय सकल विपद भक्ति विनोद बोले जाको ओम नाम गाए,
बोले जा कौन ओ नाम गाए,
राधा कृष्ण बोल बोल बोलो रे सुभाए,
राधा कृष्ण बोल बोल बोलो रे सुभाए,
शिक्षा दिया सपना दिया फिर से ने ते गौर निताए, मिचे मायार बसे जाच्छो बेशे काट हो बुडू गुबा,
मिचे मायार बसे जाच्छो बेशे काट हो बुडू गुबा,
राधा कृष्ण बोल बोल बोलो रे सुभाए,
राधा कृष्ण बोल बोल बोलो रे सुभाए,
हरे कृष्णा हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे रामा हरे रामा राम रामा हरे हरे,
हरे कृष्णा
कृष्णा कृष्णा हरे हरे,
हरे राम 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 हरे हरे,
हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे रामा 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 हरे हरे,
हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे रामा राम राम हरे हरे,
हरे कृष्णा हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे रामा राम राम हरे हरे,
हरे कृष्णा
हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे,
हरे राम 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 हरे हरे,
हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम हरे राम 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 हरे हरे,
हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम हरे राम 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 हरे हरे,
हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे,
हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे,
जय जय राधे जय जय श्याम जय जय श्री वृंदावन धाम,
जय जय श्याम जय जय श्री वृंदावन धाम,
जय जय राधे जय जय श्याम जय जय श्री वृंदावन धाम,
जय जय राधे जय श्याम जय जय श्री वृंदावन धाम,
जय जय श्री चैतन्य जय नित्यानंद, जय जय श्री चैतन्य जय नित्यानंद, जय द्वैत चंद्र जय गौर भक्त वृंद,
जय द्वैत चंद्र जय गौर भक्त वृंद,
जय जय श्री चैतन्य जय नित्यानंद, जय द्वैत चंद्र जय गौर भक्त वृंद,
जय द्वैत चंद्र जय गौर भक्त वृंद,
जय जय श्री चैतन्य जय नित्यानंद,
जय
द्वैत चंद्र जय गौर भक्त वृंद, पावन हरिनाम संकीर्तन की। हरे कृष्णा। ओम ज्ञानतिमिरांधस्य ज्ञानांजनशलाकया चक्षुः उन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः। श्री चैतन्य मनोभीष्टं स्थापितं येन भूतले स्वयं रूपः कदा मह्यं ददाति स्वपदांतिकम्। वंदेहं श्रीगुरोः श्रीयुतापदकमलं श्रीगुरून् वैष्णवांश्च श्रीरूपं साग्रजातं सहगणरघुनाथान्वितं तं सजीवं साद्वैतं सावधूतं परिजनासहितं कृष्णचैतन्यदेवं श्रीराधाकृष्णपादान् सहगणललिता श्री विशाखान्वितांश्च। नमः ओम विष्णुपादाय कृष्णपृष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदांत स्वामिनिति नामिने। नमस्ते सारस्वते देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेषशून्यवादी पाश्चात्यदेशतारिणे वाञ्छाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्य एव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः। जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्तवृंद। हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू फॉर द चैतन्य चरितामृत 24th चैप्टर ऑफ द मध्य लीला।
So we have been doing the verses, meaning of different words of the famous verse, Atma Ramashchamaniya verse. We have been gradually progressing. And we completed up to which verse? Last? 106 we have finished. Now 107 onwards starts 61 explanations of the Atmarama verse. And if you go verse by verse, it's going to be very difficult because there are many technical names being used. Even yesterday I felt it was very technical, it might have been a bit difficult. But it's very beautifully presented in a tabular format and a flowchart type of format, which I had spoken in one of the Srimad Bhagavatam classes, which I felt I will play that for you, and you will find it very easy to capture this. So all these things are explained there very nicely. So yeah, up to 312, up to 310, up to 310 verse of this chapter, that means beginning with 107 to 310. So you will get the explanations very easily, you will understand it now. And then we can appreciate it, and then we go to 311 in the next class. So, So, I will show you from where, from just 1 minute. Okay, Dad? But timing I have to tell you.
Okay.
You can play, let us start with this.
Prabhupada wants to promote Bhakti Marga. So he's criticizing all the other margas, like Jnana Marga, Yoga Marga. Like that they think. Or they think Prabhupada wants to promote Krishna, so he is criticizing all demigods. This is a very superficial material outlook. Therefore, I thought that devotees should know much deeper understanding of this concept which Prabhupada has explained in his Chaitanya Charitamrita very deeply, Madhya Leela 24th, based on Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's 61 explanations of Atmarama verse to Sanatana Goswami. So by understanding it, you will be amazed what kind of deep analysis Mahaprabhu has done of jnanis, yogis, karmis, bhaktas, everybody. Like once when I was in Bengal, there was one elderly gentleman wearing a tilak like this, like our tilak. And he and his good wife, they both were almost 65 to 70 years of age. So his son was known to me. So when I was talking to his son told that my parents have decided to leave home and go to the matha of their guru. They want to become vanaprasthas and stay there and do service. So he just told me, just talk a few words to my father. So I just, Hare Krishna, I wished him. And then I was seeing the tilak on his forehead, I said, oh, very happy, you are also a Gaudiya Vaishnava. I said, you are wearing the Gaudiya tilak. And then he told me, not exactly, he said. Then he asked, then what? Then you are wearing tilak, he said. We follow the path of Chaitanya Pat Shankaramat, he said. Chaitanya Pat Shankaramat. Which means they want to use bhakti as a tool for attaining the jnana goal, which is to merge in Brahman. But one thing becomes evident from that fellow's talk, what Prabhupada says here in today's purport, that even the path of jnana and yogis, they take help of bhakti path to achieve elevation in their own paths also, leave alone any bhakti. That one of ours, we may not be able to cover the whole chapter, we will cover as much as we can. See, Sanatana Goswami humbly requested Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He told him that Sanatana Goswami told him that you have previously explained to Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya 18 different ways of this verse. You all know this famous verse. Atma Ramashchamanayo Nirgranta Apyurukrame Kurvan Tahaitukim Bhaktim Ittham Bhuta Gunoharihi That's the verse. This verse appears in the Srimad Bhagavatam. Atmanamascha Munayaha means, somebody may ask a question. Shagadeva Goswami went to forest to practice impersonal meditation. But then why did he come back? To whom? You know, did he become attracted to, you know, getting married and settled at home? No. Was he attached to his father? Never. Already he left his father who was calling Putra Putra, he never looked back. Then, did he get bored with spiritual life? No. He was very fully realized jnani, cheerfully situated. He didn't come because of that. Was he afraid of some lions and tigers in the forest? No. He was completely fearless. Gatabhi. He had become free from all fear in the forest also. Or was he not sufficiently learned in knowledge? Oh, what to speak of knowledge? He was a fully realized jnani. He was deeply learned, vastly learned, and he was fully realized. There was no shortage of knowledge also. So in this way, there is an analysis about Shukadeva Goswami returning home. But then why did he return home? This verse says that, Atma Ramascha Munayaha Nirgranta Apyurukrame. Those who have become free from all material bondage, and they are Atmaramas, completely satisfied in their self. Even such people, he is saying, Atmaramascha Munayaha. Even such kinds of people also, Kurvanti Ahaitukim Bhaktim. They develop attraction to perform Ahaituki Bhakti. Ittam Bhuta Guno Harihi. Such is the quality of Lord Hari. Lord Hari can attract even the monists who have already attained peace of mind and na shochati na kankshati. They have no hankering of material enjoyment. They have no lamentation for losing anything in the world. Some of them were only kaupin. Kaupinavanta, kalubhagyavanta, vedanta, vakyeshu sadaramanta, it is said. They are always studying the Vedanta, wearing a kaupi and sitting in Himalayas, Om chanting, satisfied. But even such Atmaramas become attracted to Krishna. Such is his beauty. So Mahaprabhu had given 18 explanations to Swarupa Bhattacharya. Now Sanatana reminded Mahaprabhu of that. Can you please, like for example, Atmarama, it has got multiple meanings. It means, like when you say Atma, the Atma also means Deha, or Mana, or Atma, or Brahman. It also means, you know, Swabhava, which means the nature, natural characteristic, or Dhriti, which means firmness, and Buddhi, and also Prayatna. So all these terms are called by one word, which is called Atma. Atma has so many meanings. So Mahaprabhu first gave the list of meanings. And the cha is used for connecting the meaning to give a collective understandings. Multiple meanings he gave like that. Similarly, Munayaha, when you say, Munaya means one who is thoughtful, Manana Shila, that's one meaning. Also, Muni means one who is silent and grave, Mauni. One who is a tapasvi, ascetic. One who is a vrati, who takes great vows, is also called Munayaha. One who is a yati, in sannyasa order, is also called Munayaha. Or one who is a rishi, saint. So many different meanings are possible for the word Muni. Munayaha means munis. And then Nirgrantha has a double meaning. One meaning is what? Nirgrantha means they have become free from all material bondage because they are so exalted. Another meaning is Nirgrantha means ruthless fellow who never follows any regulative principles. He is the most degraded two-legged animal. Like that. See, here are the different meanings. Avidya Grantihina. That means those who become free from the knots of ignorance. At the same time, it also means Vidhi Nisheda Veda Shastra Vihina. He is saying. So, he has no Vidhi or Nisheda, do's and don'ts. Neither does he know them. And he has no knowledge of the Shastra. He is Vihin. Such a person is also called Nirgranti. And jnanadi vihira means he has no knowledge. If he is another meaning is murkha, which means illiterate. Or nicha means low born. Mlecha means misbehaved person. Or also Shastra Rikta Gana means, you know, he knows little Shastra, but he has no respect for Shastra also. Or he is Dhana Sanchayi. He is also called as Nirgrantha means, you know, he doesn't follow any norm of cheating, no cheating, no. He is simply Dhana Sanchayi. He makes money without caring for morality. Or Nirgrantha also means one who has no riches, Nirdhana. Dhana Sanchayi, Nirdhana, both can be called by the name Nirgrantha. Like that Mahaprabhu said, these are multiple meanings possible for Nirgrantha. And then, yeah, now in this way then he told about the word api also. Api means used in the sense of a possibility or a question or doubt, or aggregating all these things. Then Urukrama also, he told many meanings. See, Urukrama means, you know the word krama in Sanskrit means step. One whose step is very great, Urukrama. Big step. From Bhumi he took his leg and put it in the sky. Urukrama, that's one meaning. Also Urukrama also means power or Shakti. Or one who captures all the planets and makes them tremble. That is the meaning of Kampa. He creates trembling as you see here. That's another meaning. And also Urukrama. Krama means systematically doing something. That is also Paripati, we call it. Or Urukrama also means Yukti, argument. Or Urukrama means Akramana. Like for example, coming forward, putting a big step very boldly to attack a person. That's called Urukrama. So in this way, Lord Vamanadeva captured all the planets and causing them to tremble. So that is one of the meanings. These are the meanings of the Urukrama word. And why Lord is called by the name Urukrama? Because he expands his external energy and creates all the material universes. Similarly, he maintains the spiritual world by his conjugal potency. By his six opulences, he maintains all the Vaikunthas. So in this way, he is practically permeating Vaikunthas, Goloka and material world everywhere. So it's called Urukrama. Like that Mahaprabhu explained. So Krama is also used in the sense of Shakti also. Okay, now then Kurvanti he explained. Kurvanti means Krishna Sukha Nimitta. For the sake of giving pleasure to Krishna, we do something for others. That is called Kurvanti. Because the Atmaramas generally do ultimate good. They don't do just a petty good or very tiny good. They do ultimate good. So therefore he is calling it as a Krishna Sukha Nimitta. Like a devotee is giving a cookie to a beggar. At the same time, he is making the beggar chant Hare Krishna also. Because he knows that this will begin his devotional service. And then Ahaituki. Ahaituki means without any motives of bhukti, mukti, siddhi. That is Ahaituki. The bhukti, how many types of bhukti? He says unlimited types of bhukti. Because shabda, sparsha, rasa, rupa, gandha, there are five pleasures, and which in combination with different sense objects can be multiplied. So, and then siddhi, generally we know 8 types. There are 18 types of siddhi. There are more siddhis other than 8 also. And then mukti, there are 5 types of mukti. You all know, salokya, sarushti, samipya, like that there are sayujya, there are 5 types of muktis. So, ahaituki means without any motives of bhukti, mukti, siddhi. That is ahaituki. And then the meaning of the word bhakti is also explained. Bhakti has 10 meanings, he says. One meaning of bhakti is sadhana bhakti, which we all are doing. And then there are 9 more types of bhakti called prema bhakti. Rati, prema, sneha, mana, pranaya, raga, anuraga, bhava, mahabhava. Now, what is the advantage in knowing these 9 types? You see, the shanta bhaktas, at the most they can prema. The dasya bhaktas, they can go at the most up to raga. And then the vatsalya bhaktas and sakhya bhaktas, they can go up to anuraga. And those who are gopis, they can go even up to the last, which is mentioned, mahabhava. They can go up to that. Which means these are all deeper and deeper amounts of intensity of bhakti. So he gives the 10 meanings of the word bhakti. And then he is saying, ittam bhuta gunaha. means he is saying bhakti is such purnanandamaya word he is using, that in comparison to the ocean of bhakti, the brahmananda is like a straw. That's one example given. Another example given in Hari Bhakti Sudodai, very famous verse. In comparison to the bhakti ananda, which is a ocean, the brahmananda, or brahma sukham, that is like only a hoof print of a calf. Whatever water can be contained in a hoof print of a calf, you can compare this to. So Prahlad Maharaj quotes this. You will see that in Prahlad Maharaj section also, he says, "My dear Lord, the happiness of materialists is like a drop of the ocean of Brahmananda, what the Brahmavadis are experiencing. But the Brahmananda in relation to Bhakti Ananda is only like a water in a hoof print of a calf compared to the ocean of Bhakti Ananda devotees feel." So like that is making a... Now, what is so special about this Bhakti Ananda? How do the devotees get Bhakti Ananda? For that one has to understand the guna of Krishna, qualities of Krishna.
Sarvarakshaka sarvahladaka maharasayana apanarabale kare sarvavismarana.
He is telling Krishna is sarva akarshaka, means he is all attractive. Sarva haladaka means he has all the mellows necessary to satisfy different devotees differently. The gopis need conjugal love. Now vatsalya love is needed by mothers and fathers, and sakya rasa is required by the friends, and then the servants of Krishna want Krishna to treat them like a dasas. And in this way Krishna treats different people differently. Their prema for them to express, he is a sarva haladaka, he delights everybody according to their rasa. So he says, so in this way, bound by Krishna's mercy, the devotees experience Krishna's uncommon power and qualities. And he says that as the devotees progress in this bliss, they have no more scriptural arguments. Because in the early stage of spiritual life, you get so many doubts, so many skeptical thoughts, so many questions, so many contradictions unresolved in the mind. The bliss of bhakti is a practical proof for the devotee, which floods the heart of the devotee, where all the questions come to a halt and the devotee becomes stunned, he says, by that maharasayana, he is saying. So in this way, Krishna's opulence, sweetness and mercy, they are all perfect and full. And what is so special about Krishna's mercy, he says that he gives himself to his devotees. There is a verse which Sudama Brahmana's wife is in Dwaraka, so you have to go. You should definitely go and meet your friend, she says. And then she says, she knows very well, my husband is an exalted husband. He is not a man going to beg some petty riches from Krishna. So she wanted to tell something very pleasing to the heart of her husband. So what she said?
Smarataha pada kamalam atmanam apiyachati.
Those devotees who remember Krishna lovingly, Krishna gives himself to his devotees, like that she said. And Sudama, as soon as he heard it, he had a jerk immediately. He felt great bliss. Yes, very true. My dear good wife, I will definitely go now.
Smarataha pada kamalam atmanam apiyachati.
He gives himself to his devotees. That is the most special quality of Krishna. So, now here comes the point. So, the qualities of Krishna which attracted devotees' minds. For example, here all the examples Mahaprabhu is giving now. The four Kumaras' minds, how were they attracted? By smelling the fragrance of the tulasi leaf in the lotus feet of the Supreme Lord.
Tasya Aravinda Nayanasya Pada Aravinda Kinjal Kamishra Tulasi Makaranda Vayoho Antargatasva Vivareda Chakara Tesham Sankshopamakshara Jusham Apichitta Tanvoho.
Their fixity on Omkar became agitated when they smelled the fragrance of the tulasi leaf from Lord's lotus feet. So the lotus feet tulasi smell charmed the hearts of Kumaras. And Chukadeva's mind, what happened to that? He was carried away by hearing the pastimes of Krishna in the forest. When he heard those woodcutters singing,
बर्हापीडम नटवर वपु कर्णयोर्कर्णिकारम बिभ्रद्वास कनक कपिशम वैजयंतीम च मालाम रंध्रान वेणोरदर सुदया पूरयन गोप वृंदैर वृंदारण्यम स्वपद रमणम प्राविशद गीत कीर्तिहि.
This pastime of Krishna playing on his flute, surrounded by his friends, colorfully decorated and dressed, entering the forest of Raj, taking the cows and calves with him, and Krishna's merciful future of liberating Putana by sucking her breast milk from her. You know? These two pastimes charmed the heart of Shukadeva Goswami. Parinishitopi Nairgunya, it is said. Although he was a liberated soul, he was still attracted. And how was the gopis' minds attracted by Krishna's beautiful bodily features, like his curly locks of hair falling in, you know, on both sides of his shoulders, and his long shark-shaped earrings, which were moving to and fro, and the cheeks were shining with the glitter of the earrings. And Krishna had a beautiful smile and a broad chest. So the gopis were attracted by Krishna's beautiful appearance. Okay, the queens of Dwaraka, how were they attracted? Like Rukmini, simply by hearing about the transcendental qualities of Krishna and beauty of Krishna.
Shrutva gunan bhuvana sundara shunvatamte nirvishyakarna vivarai haratongatapam rupam drisham drishimatam akhilartalabham tvayyachyuta vishati chitta papatrapam me.
She's telling anybody who has eyes Krishna in this world, the perfection of the eyes to see your beauty, and one should observe your good qualities. Simply by hearing about them, my mind is sold out to you. Neither, she is telling. So by hearing the qualities of Krishna, then the goddesses of fortune like Lakshmis, how are they attracted to Krishna? She was attracted by the vibration of the transcendental flute, and she was attracted to the dust of Krishna's lotus feet. Two things.
कस्यानुभावोऽस्य न देव विद्महे तवाङ्ग्रिरेणुस्परशाधिकार यद्वाञ्छया श्रीललनाचरत्तपो विहाय कामान् सुचिरं धृतव्रताः.
क्लियरली इट सेज़ यद्वाञ्छया श्री लक्ष्मीजी हैड द वाञ्छा. वाट वाञ्छा? ललना अचरत्तपो. शी डिड अ वेरी ग्रेट पेनेंस फॉर वाट? तवाङ्ग्रिरेणु स्पर्श. शी वांटेड Krishna's angri renu sparsha. She wanted the dust of Krishna's lotus feet on her head. That was the attraction for her. She always likes to serve the Lord at his lotus feet. So she was amazed by, because she never has heard Vishnu playing flute. Vishnu only carries his Sankha Chakra Gada Padma. Whereas here her Lord is playing on the flute. So she became very attracted, and he is dancing also very beautifully. So she was attracted to those features also. And the young girls in all the three worlds, they are all attracted to Krishna's sweet flute songs. And Krishna's beauty stands, he says, even the cows and birds and animals and trees. The trees are generally not very conscious, they are very dull creatures. They just stand like this. But when Krishna comes to the forest, immediately the trees also are shaking, they are vibrating with great affection for Krishna. They are feeling longing and separation that we can't go with Krishna the forest. Look at the bumblebees, they are all accompanying Krishna. But we are all stuck in the ground in one place, we can't move. So thinking like this, that trees are crying tears in the form of gums, flowing from the tears. And they are yielding the flowers and fruits to Krishna. So in this way, and then he is saying the meaning of Hari has two meanings. Sarva Amangala Hare Iti Hari. That's one meaning. One who takes away all inauspiciousness. And second meaning is Premadiya Hareman. He gives his love and steals the hearts of all living beings, like that. So he is called as a tapahari, you know. Krishna takes away four kinds of sins. What are they? Pataka, urupataka, mahapataka, ati pataka. Four types of sins. Pataka means, you know, preliminary sin. And then urupataka means, oh, uru means great, great pataka, great sin. And mahapataka means much, much greater sin. Atipataka means, don't even talk about it. Terrible sins. But Krishna can take away all the sinful reactions. Aham tvam sarva papebhyo Mokshayishyami. So he is capable of that. So therefore he called as a Hari. Sarva Amangala Hare Iti Hari. That's the meaning of that. And then in this way he goes ahead. Now we are coming to the You all know this. Jnana, Yoga, Bhakti. These are all different ways to attain Krishna's lotus feet eventually. So now there are three types of devotees who are Akama Bhaktas, Mokshakama Bhaktas, Sarvakama Bhaktas. Like that. And we give up all bad association by three things he says. Sadhu Sangha, association with the devotee, and Krishna Kripa, mercy of Krishna, and Bhakti, nature of devotion service. By this one is charmed and one can give up all bad association and go towards Krishna. Now starts the Atmarama verse, meaning explanation from here onwards, the 61 meanings. Like here you see this table. So here it is given. See, there is Jnana Marg and Antaryami Upasaka. You are able to see these two broad categories. Like that in their group of Jnanis also, these three categories are there. Sadhaka means, you know, just now, he has made a beginning and he is now, he is a beginner, but nearing perfect execution of Brahman realization. Which means he is practicing meditation on the Brahman. Example is giving in Navayugendras. But the most important thing is mentioned here, how Brahma Upasakas, who all became Krishna's devotees. Like this Navayugendras, when they were practicing meditation on Brahman, they heard about Krishna's qualities. Ittam Bhuta Gunohari. From whom? From Brahma, Shiva and Narada. And they ended up becoming devotees. And they finally achieved Rangakshetra as their most worshipable abode. Ranganath became their most lovable lord for all the Navayugendras. That means, one thing becomes very clear. Like Prabhupada gives the example, when you are going in the train, you know, the mountains look very hazy like a cloud. Sometimes the train goes more nearer to the mountain. Then you find more details, greenery and all you find. Then the train goes even more near the mountain. Then you find a hut. You know, some people are walking up, walking down. There are some cows, calves. They are also herding there. So the mountain is same. And the details are same. Sadhaka, I told you, Navagendra example. Then Brahma Maya means, see the word Maya. Brahma Maya means absorbed in Brahman. They are more advanced, these people. And the example is given Shukadeva Goswami. You all know that as soon as he was born, he was walking towards the forest and there were some ladies taking baths. And the ladies observed that this personality is Brahman realized. He doesn't see difference between man and woman. He sees a soul in each body. Pandita Samadarshinaha. That type of vision he has. So they saw he was Brahma Maya, absorbed. He was above bodily consciousness. He had no mental attachments. So such a Brahma Maya Shukadeva Goswami, I told you. He became attracted to Krishna's pastimes and mercy, and then he returned to home and heard Bhagavatam from Veda Vyas. Isn't it? Then Prapta Brahma Laya, he says. That means one who is actually merged in Brahman. Is absorbed in, so completely absorbed in Brahman. Like for example, the Kumaras. They actually had reached the Brahma Jyoti. They reached the door of Vaikuntha. Also. But there, in Dora Vaikuntha, they got the Tulasi aromas. Even in that mature stage of fully realized with Brahman, they became devotees. Yeah. And then these are all Brahma Upasakas. Then there are Moksha Kangshi. See, the Moksha Kangshi, there are three categories. Mumokshu, Jivan Mukta, Prapta Swarupa. Three categories. In the Mumokshu category, that means now Mumokshu, Bubukshu, this term you must have heard. Bhubukshu means one who is hankering for material enjoyment. Mumukshu means one who is hankering for liberation. Oh, I want to get rid of cycle of birth and death. No, I want to go beyond it. Such a person. So the Shaunakadi rishis were like that. Shaunaka rishi, along with the 88,000 disciples, And they were performing the yajna. But their goal was, they were mumukshus. And then their faces are becoming black. And the smoke was painful to the eyes. At that time, they came across Sutta Goswami, who spoke the Srimad Bhagavatam. After having heard that, Shaunakad Rishi and his disciples became so jubilant.
Tanno bhavan vai bhagavat pradano mahattamayakanta parayanasya.
And then, nantam gunanam agunasya jagmur yogeshwaraye bhavapad mamukhyaha. This is the first verse. Another verse they are saying,
tanno bhavan vai bhagavat pradano mahattamayakanta parayanasya harerudaram charitam vishuddham shushrushatam no vitanotu vidvan.
These two famous verses they said. Is very magnanimous, and you are a Bhagavat Pradhan, one who is always absorbed in Supreme Lord, and we are Shushrushatam, very eager to hear, and nectar is flowing in your katha. And then they said, we were actually performing this yajna, but after hearing your katha, we are already liberated while hearing the katha only. What to speak of having heard the complete katha, I'm meditating on the personality Krishna, you know, you get much more than liberation. Liberation has become peanuts for us. It's insignificant for us now. Like that they said. So in this way, the mumukshu. And Jivan Mukta, one who is Jivan Mukta is already liberated in this life. See, Jivan Mukta can be compared to a supari which is dried up. You know? Kudu 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 sound comes and it is withdrawn inside. Or even this coconut. Coconut which is withdrawn inside. It becomes... Cobra, we call it, no? Cobra. So it was like that, they are liberated souls. They have liberated themselves from the gross body and subtle body. They are completely aloof. They are called Jivan Mukta. Yeah. The example is Bill Mangal Thakur. It's given here. You can see that. Actually, such Jivan Muktas wander without any cares. But he became attracted to Krishna's qualities and engaged. So, there is a beautiful verse. Just 1 minute, I'll show you. This is a song written by Billu Mangal. Maduram maduram vapurasya vibhor. Bole. Maduram maduram vadanam maduram. Madugandhi mridusmita metadaho. Maduram 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 maduram. This is Chaitanya Charitamrita Madhyalila 21.136. So he is saying, Maduram Maduram Vapurasya Vibhor. Oh, my Supreme Lord Krishna's body itself is so beautiful. Maduram Maduram, it is sweet, sweet, he is saying. Then two sweets for Krishna's body and three sweets for his face. Maduram Maduram Vadanam Maduram. And then he is saying, in that face, so even such a Jivan Mukta personality, he became attracted to Krishna like this. And then jnane, in the Jivan Mukta, there are two types of Jivan Mukta. Bhaktiya Jivan Mukta, jnane Jivan Mukta. This is very important. See, Bhaktiya Jivan Mukta means the Jivan Mukta gradually becomes interested in Krishna deeply like Bilva Mangal. Most fortunate fellows. Because he didn't get misled. But the jnane Jivan Mukta, they fall down. They are the people who are called A and A. Aravindaksha Vimukta Maninaha Tvayasta Bhava Adavishuddha Buddheha Aruhya Kritsrena Param Padam Tataha Patanti Ado Anadrati Vishmadangreha. Because of offending the Supreme Lord, considering his form to be ordinary, made of flesh and blood, such personalities who are called Jnane Jivan Mukta. These people liberated through philosophical speculation without taking help of bhakti. So these jnanis fall down. So here the point is very clear. That means out of two Jivan Muktas, Bhaktiya Jivan Mukta goes to Bhakti path, is liberated, and he becomes a sweet devotee, like Bilva Mangal, just now we heard. And Jnane Jivan Mukta refuses to take shelter of Krishna. Initially takes shelter of Krishna, but he becomes doubtful. I think Krishna's body is like our body only. Then he offends Krishna. Then he takes a U-turn and comes back. He falls down. And then there is Prapta Swarupa. Who is this Jnani? One who has attained Muktir Hitva Anyata Arupam Swarupena Vavastiti. These are the people who are on the strength of bhakti, they attain a spiritual body. They liberated from Maya, liberated from fear also, Bhayam Dvitiyad. And then after getting liberation, you know, they worship Krishna very intensely and they attain the Swarupa. Mukti Ritva Anita Rupam Swarupena. These are all people who began as Moksha Kangshi. They aspired for Moksha and then they rejected Moksha. Just like Prabhupada Saraswati says, you know, Kaivalyam Narakayate Tridashapura Akasha Pushpayate Durdantindriya Kala Sarpapatali Protkhata Damshtrayate Vishwam Purna Sukhayate Vidimahendra Dishchakitayate Yatkarunya Vai Bababavatam Tam Gaurame Vastumaha. He's telling, by mercy of Lord Gaura or Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, a person considers moksha like a hell because there is no seva for Krishna there. He doesn't want moksha. And the upper, lower and middle worlds of this material world, especially the higher worlds, he considers them like a phantasmagoria, not attracted to that. And then the sense objects and the senses, which are always compared to the serpent's poisonous tooth, that tooth is broken to pieces. A bhakta has no attraction for sense gratification. And he considers the posts like Brahma's post and Indra's post to be like a kida, he says, like a worm in the stool, he says. So in this way, for even the material world, which is Dukalayam Ashashvatam for the common people, bhakta considers it Vishwam Purna Sukhayate, because he takes everything in this world and engages in Krishna service, like that. So in this way, similarly, you can see the so all these Brahma Upasakas and Moksha Kangshis, totally 3 plus 3, 6 of them, when they were in the platform of Brahman worship, you add cha to them. And you add cha, Atma Ramas cha Muniya. Then that becomes a 7th category. All these 6 people, therefore he is saying Atma Rama plus cha, Atma Ramaha cha, which means Atma Ramascha means all these 6 Atma Ramas, when they take to devotional service, then they all become bhaktas in one category. Put all of them. They all are devotees now. And then the 8th to 13th, who are the other 6 categories? Antaryami Upasaka. In that, the you see, there is Yogaru Rukshu, Yogaruda and Prapta Siddhi. In that, there is a Sagarbha and Nirgarbha. Sagarbha means those who meditate on the Vishnu form, and Nigarva means those who meditate on impersonal Brahma Jyoti. 2 categories of people. And Yogaru Rukshu is the neophyte stage, Yogarud is the mature stage, and Prapta Siddhi is the perfected stage. So like that, there are 3. Sagarbha, Yogaru Rukshu and Yogarud and Prapta Siddhi. So here the yogi is meditating on the Vishnu form in their heart. And he is desiring only Ashta Siddhis. That is all. Nothing great. Although he is looking at Vishnu in the heart, in the early stage he wants only Siddhis. But then, when he is elevated to yogic perfection, meditating on Vishnu, now when he becomes a yoga ruda, now he is meditating on the Lord, no interest in sense gratification, he doesn't want Ashta Siddhis now, when he comes to yoga ruda stage. And then when it is Prapta Siddhi, they have already achieved success by meditating on the Vishnu form. So then he will go to Vaikuntha, these yogis. And then similarly, if you take the other Nigarbha yogis, those who worship the super soul but without form. So that is another category. If you see that, they struggle for impersonal meditation. And then when they attain practicing perfection, impersonal meditation, he says that the 6 yogis in association of devotees, they engage in Krishna's devotional service, being attracted by his transcendental qualities. Okay, let us imagine that Nigarbha yogi never got association of a devotee. Then what will happen? He will just be hanging in impersonal realization, that's all. He is not able to, although he has achieved perfection in impersonal realization, he cannot proceed ahead without getting association of a devotee. If he didn't get it in this life, he has to get it in next life, subsequently. So, then there are 10 types of Atmaramas mentioned here. If you see here, Atma as a mind, they are satisfied in mental speculation. So, such persons also, when they associate with a pure devotee, they take to Krishna Bhakti and they become very great saints. So, 10.87.8, there is a reference given here also. There is an example given. They are called as Sakaraksha. Shakaraksha and mystic yogis. Yeah. So, initially they started with considering Atma as the mind. They are mental speculators. And then these second category fellows, Atma as endeavor, they endeavor with great sincerity, seriousness and ulterior motives. And then again, when they associate with devotees, like Narada Muni, advised Veda Vyasa to try to attend devotion service, and nothing else. So, there are people who make endeavor, but in their endeavor, if bhakti is combined, initially they were making material endeavor, then it becomes a spiritual endeavor. Similarly, Atma has dhriti. Like he says, even dull creatures, birds and illiterates can also be situated in endurance. Like sometimes you find that trees can tolerate a lot. But he says that but they can, and then and they engage in devotion service. Like birds attracted by Krishna's flute, bees glorifying Balaram, Kirata Honandra. Then they become connected to devotion service. Actually, the birds in Krishna Lila, they are all sages who are sitting in their trees and rapt to meditation, hearing Krishna's flute. They are all sages. And then the Atma has a buddhi. And then in this way, you see, these are the earlier meanings I told you of the word Atma. So, six meanings are derived from this. And then another seven type of Atmaramas, Atma as a body and Atma, and then like this, he is saying, then the 20th meaning, let us see. Yeah, Atma as a buddhi, Atma as a swabhava. Similarly, then there are four explanations considering the meaning of Atma to be deha, body. Aupadika Brahmadeha. It's called as Sharkarakas, who worship Brahman from abdomen and gradually rise to the heart where Paramatma is situated. And Karmanishta Yagnikera Karmadeha. Sages at Naimisharanya had Vaishavanaka began fruity sacrifice but became pleased with the nectar of the lotus feet to Govinda, he says. Then Tapo Deha. Then Sarvakama Deha. Sarvakama Deha is a Dhruva Maharaj. So, in this way, for some we have examples, for some we don't have examples. So, and then he goes ahead, three more explanations of Atmanama verse based on, see, he is giving the hunter Mrigari and Nardamani's example comes here. Like here he says, even the hunter in the association of pure devotee becomes worshipable, puja, and the best of devotees, Bhagavatottama. And Mahaprabhu here tells the story of Mrigari. Here is where he quotes Vyada. So, he was actually Nirgrantha. In what sense? He had no rules that he followed. He was complete Nirgrantha. And he was a Nirdhana Nirgrantha. He was a Vyada. And how he became a devotee. So, and then 32 more explanations on the verse are coming here. You will see in the next page. See, these 32 types, how it is made, you can see here. Personal associates are called Parishada. Perfected in devotion service, Sadhana Siddha. Mature in practicing devotee, Jata Rati Sadhaka. Immature in practicing devotee, Ajata Rati. Jata Rati, Ajata Rati. Rati not yet awakened. And then in that, there are categories. Dasa, Sakya, and then superiors, like Vatsalya. And the prayasis. Prayasis are the kanta. So, in this way, servants, friends,
parental affection and lovers. So in that there is Vidhi Bhakta and Raga Bhakti. Two categories are there. So in this way, this now we have come into the Bhakta Yogis category. After completing the Jnana, Yoga and Bhakti. Yeah. So in this way, Mahaprabhu gave 61 explanations of Atmarama verse. So, see, one thing I can tell you at the end of the class today, although you may not remember all the 61 explanations, you know, it's pretty exhaustive, but one most important thing in this class is this. Here he says that transcendental practices that do not ultimately help one realize the Supreme Personality of Godhead are useless, be they mystic yoga practice, analytical study of matter, severe austerity, acceptance of sannyas, or the study of Vedic literature. All these may be very important aspects of spiritual advancement, but unless one understands the Supreme Personality of Godhead Hari, all these processes are useless. And then the Prabhupada says in the purport here, the impersonalists wish to merge into Supreme Brahman. However, merging into Supreme Brahman also requires a touch of devotional service. For that I took this section. Now Brahma Upasak and then the yogis, both the six categories I showed you. So all of them are eventually getting in touch with devotional service. And then some of them attain the impersonal goal if they still have an attachment to it. Just like somebody has Pururava had a strong material attachment to Urvashi. So he foolishly worshipped Lord Vishnu and told Vishnu, please give me my Urvashi back. So somebody may still go to, you know, material attachment. Similarly, some impersonal upasaks, even after hearing about Krishna, they may take support of Krishna and still may request Krishna to give them moksha. That category is also there. But the point is they are taking help of Krishna. That's the thing. Whether it is Pururava for material enjoyment, some impersonalist for Brahma Jyoti, whatever it is. So the bhakti touch is required for karmis, jnanis, yogis, all of them, even to achieve their goal. So therefore, even if you want to be happy materially, without Krishna's blessing, nobody can be happy. So it is in the interest of every jiva that they connect with Krishna through the path of bhakti. And if you already are working on the straightforward sadhana bhakti, we are most fortunate, because otherwise if you are jnani, yogi and all, after million lifetimes you will come back. Bahunam janma namante. Whereas being a bhakta, right now we can directly proceed straight to Krishna's lotus feet and eternal service.
So, you saw the 61 explanations. Now let us proceed further from text number 311.
Shati artha kahilu sab Krishna ra bhajane. Sei artha haye sab udharane.
I have just explained 60 different meanings, and all of them aim at the service of Lord Krishna. After giving so many examples, that is the only meaning, like that Lord Chaitanya says.
Ekashashti artha ebe sphurila toma sange.
Ekashashti artha ebe sphurila
toma sange. Tomara bhakti vashe ute artera tarange.
Now, due to your association, another meaning has awakened. It is due to your devotional service that these waves of meaning are arising.
Like the Lord Chaitanya is glorifying Sanatana Goswami. Purport.
The word Atma refers to the living entity. From Lord Brahma down to an insignificant ant, everyone is considered a living entity. Living entities are considered part of the Lord's marginal potency. All of them are Kshetragya, knowers of the body. When they become nirgrantha or free, saintly persons, they engage in Lord Krishna's service. That is the 61st meaning of the verse.
Yeah. So when they become nirgrantha or free, say, saintly persons, then they can engage in Lord Krishna's service. Ultimately.
Aham vedmi shuko veti.
Aham vedmi shuko veti.
Vyaso veti na veti va.
Vyaso
भक्त्या भागवतं ग्राह्यं न बुद्ध्या न च टीकया।
लॉर्ड शिवा सेड, आई मे नो सुखदेव गोस्वामी द सन ऑफ व्यास देवा मे नो एंड व्यास देवा मे नो और मे नॉट नो श्रीमद भागवतम। ऑन द होल श्रीमद भागवतम द स्पॉटलेस पुराणा कैन बी लर्न्ड ओनली थ्रू डिवोशनल सर्विस नॉट बाय मटेरियल इंटेलिजेंस स्पेक्युलेटिव मेथड और इमेजिनरी कमेंट्रीज। डिवोशनल सर्विस इंक्लूड्स 9 प्रोसेस बिगिनिंग विथ हियरिंग चैंटिंग एंड रिमेंबरिंग द एक्टिविटीज ऑफ लॉर्ड विष्णु। ओनली वन हु हैज टेकन टू डिवोशनल सर्विस कैन अंडरस्टैंड श्रीमद भागवतम विच इज द स्पॉटलेस पुराण फॉर अ ट्रांसेंडेंटलिस्ट परमहंसा। सो कॉल्ड कमेंट्रीज आर यूजलेस फॉर दिस पर्पज। अकॉर्डिंग टू द वैदिक इंजक्शन यश्य देवे परा भक्तिर यथा देवे तथा गुरव श्वेत उपनिषद 6.23। ऑल वैदिक लिटरेचर्स मेंटेन दैट श्रीमद भागवतम हैज टू बी लर्न्ड फ्रॉम द पर्सन भागवत एंड टू अंडरस्टैंड इट वन हैज टू इंगेज इन प्योर डिवोशनल सर्विस। श्रीमद भागवतम कैन नॉट बी अंडरस्टूड बाय सो कॉल्ड एरुडिट स्कॉलर्स और ग्रामेरियंस। वन हु हैज डेवलप्ड प्योर कृष्णा कॉन्शियसनेस एंड हैज सर्व्ड द प्योर डिवोटी द स्पिरिचुअल मास्टर कैन अंडरस्टैंड श्रीमद भागवतम, अदर्स कैन नॉट।
सो नाउ हियर Why is it said that Lord Shiva says that I may know because Shiva is Krishna's devotee, and Sukadeva Goswami will know because he is also Krishna's devotee, and son of Vyasadeva. And then he says Vyasadeva may know or may not know. He says why? Because Vyasadeva is literal incarnation. He is the incarnation of the Supreme Lord. So Supreme Lord often doesn't know his glories as much as his devotees know. Therefore he says Vyasadeva may know or may not know. Therefore, he says, if you are a devotee, one has to actually associate with devotees and learn the Lord's glories. When Lord tells about himself, he will tell only briefly. When the devotees talk about the Lord, they will expand the Lord's glories very joyfully. Just like parents, you know, they know the son's or daughter's glory more than the son or daughter, isn't it? And parents also very joyfully glorify the parents. Therefore, he is saying, as devotees, Shiva and Sukadeva Goswami, Narada, they all know the Lord's glories. But Vyasadeva may not know because he is a literal incarnation of the Lord. So therefore, the point is one should do devotion service under the guidance of a devotee. That's the point. Otherwise, without any amount of scholarship, one cannot understand him, he says. Arthashuni sanatana vismita haiya. Sudhikare mahaprabhura charne dhariya.
After hearing all the explanation of all the different meaning of the Atmaram verse, Sanatan Goswami was struck with wonder. He fell down at the lotus feet of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and began to offer prayers.
Sakshat Ishwara Tumi Vrajendra Nandana. Tumaranishwase Sarva Veda Pravartana.
Sanatan Goswami said, My dear Lord, you are the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Krishna, the son of Maharaj Nand. All the Vedic literatures are vibrated through your breathing.
Tumi vakta bhagavatera tumi jana artha.
Tumi vakta
bhagavatera tumi jana artha. Tvavina anya janite nahi kasamartha.
My dear Lord, you are the original speaker of the Bhagavatam. You therefore know its real import. But for you, no one can understand the confidential meaning of Srimad Bhagavatam.
Yeah. Prabhupada is saying, and therefore, here, if you see pages 1 to 41, in the Bhagavatam introduction, Prabhupada talks about Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in this section. Whole thing about Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's life sketch Prabhupada gives there, in that place. So Prabhupada is saying, So therefore, like Sanatana correctly says here, you are the original speaker of Bhagavatam because you are Krishna. and you therefore know the real import. But for you, that means without you, nobody else knows. So in order to help people know who Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is, 141 pages Prabhupada devoted in explaining about Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's life sketch. Yeah. Prabhu kahe kene kara amara stavana.
Prabhu kahe kene kara amara stavana.
Bhagavate ra swarupa kene na kara vicharana.
Bhagavate ra swarupa kene na kara vicharana.
Shri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu replied, "Why are you glorifying me personally? You should understand the transcendental position of Srimad Bhagavatam. Why don't you consider this important point?"
Mahaprabhu, Sanatana is glorifying Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Mahaprabhu is diverting the glory to Srimad Bhagavatam, not ready to accept the glory himself. Krishna Tulya Bhagavata Vibhu Sarvashraya.
Krishna Tulya Bhagavata Vibhu Sarvashraya.
Prati Shloke Prati Akshare Nana Arthakaya.
Prati Shloke Prati Akshare Nana Arthakaya.
Srimad Bhagavatam is as great as Krishna, the Supreme Lord and shelter of everything. In each and every verse of Srimad Bhagavatam and in each and every syllable, there are various meanings.
That's the beauty of Bhagavatam. It's a very deep scripture. In fact, we have experienced that when many gurus, sannyasis, maharajas speak from Srimad Bhagavatam, how one pastime has so many deeper and deeper and deeper layers of realization when they come out. And also the shlokas, the words have, one word may have sometimes a dozen meanings. And great souls explain it very beautifully. And adding to that, the sweetness of the tikas of acharyas like Vishnu Chakravarti Thakur, Shridhara Swami, and Sanatana Goswami, Jiva Goswami, they bring out the meaning of the verses. So in this way, he says that Srimad Bhagavatam is like we say, Ratna Garbha, no? Ratna Garbha is the ocean from where you can take Navaratnas. Like that, Navaratna, like meanings are presented the Srimad Bhagavatam verses, and it's like Sakshat Krishna, he says. Prashnotare Bhagavate Kariyache Nirdhara.
Prashnotare Bhagavate Kariyache Nirdhara.
Yahara Shravane Loke Lage Chamatkara.
Yahara Shravane Loke Lage Chamatkara.
The form of Srimad Bhagavatam is given in questions and answers. Thus, the conclusion is established. By hearing these questions and answers, one is highly astonished.
Parikshit is asking question and Sukadeva Goswami is answering. Similarly, you find King Nimi is asking questions, Navagindra are answering. It's throughout Bhagavatam is like that. Prachina Parikshit is asking question, Narada is answering. Maitreya Vidura Sambad, Vidura Uddhava Sambad. So, and Shaunaka Drishi Sutta Goswami Sambhad. So, in this way, Bhagavatam is full of questions. Bruhi Yogeshware Krishne.
Bruhi Yogeshware Krishne.
Brahmanye Dharma Varmani.
Brahmanye Dharma Varmani.
Swam Kashtham Adhunopete.
Swam Kashtham Adhunopete.
Dharmakam Sharanam Gatah.
Dharmakam Sharanam Gatah.
Now that Shri Krishna, the Absolute Truth, the master of all mystic powers, has departed for his own abode, please tell us by whom religious principles are presently protected.
So this is 1123. This question raised by all the sages, heard by Shavanaka. The question put before the great devotee Suta Goswami is the foremost of the six questions raised. So the answer is that it is there here. The answer he explains about the Srimad Bhagavatam. Krishna Swadamo Pagate Dharma Jnana Divisaha Kalau Nashta Drishamesha Puranarko Dhunoditaha. This answer, read it.
This Bhagavat Puran is as brilliant as the sun, and it has arisen just after the departure of Lord Krishna to his own abode, accompanied by religion, knowledge, etc. Persons who have lost their vision due to the dense darkness of ignorance in the age of Kali shall get light from this Purana.
So in this way, Bhagavatam is Sakshat Krishna, like the sun giving light in darkness, dissipating darkness. Similarly, the Srimad Bhagavat Purana gives light to all the Kali Yuga Vasis whose eyes are blinded by the darkness of Kali Yuga. He says, okay, coming back to that. That's the verse we recited just now, isn't it? Ei mata kahilu eka shlokera vyakhyana. Vatulera pralapakari kekare pramana.
In this way, like a madman, I have explained the meaning of just one verse. I do not know who will take this as evidence.
Mahaprabhu, out of humility, is speaking like this. Amahena yabe keha vatulahaya.
Amahena yabe keha
vatulahaya. Yehi drishte bhagavater artha janaya.
Yehi drishte bhagavater artha janaya.
If one becomes a madman like me, he may also understand the meaning of Srimad Bhagavatam by this process.
That madman means you have to become pure devotee. That's the qualification.
Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu plainly explains that Srimad Bhagavatam cannot be understood by those who are materially situated. In other words, one has to become a madman like Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Apart from being the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is an acharya who exhibited love of God like a madman. According to his own written verse, Yukaitam Nimeshena, he says that for him, a moment seems to last 12 years. Chakshusha
Pravrishayitam.
My tears are flowing like torrents of rain. Shunyayitam Jagat Sarvam. I feel as if the entire universe were vacant. Why? Govinda Virahena me. Due to my being separated from Govinda, Krishna. One can understand Srimad Bhagavatam only by following in the footsteps of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, who was mad for Krishna. We cannot, of course, imitate Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. It is not possible. However, unless one is very serious about understanding Krishna, he cannot understand Srimad Bhagavatam. Srimad Bhagavatam gives the full narration of Krishna's transcendental activities. The first 9 cantos explain who Krishna is, and the Lord's birth and activities are narrated in the 10th canto. In the Bhagavad Gita, it is stated, Janma karma chame divyam.
Krishna's appearance and disappearance are all transcendental, not mundane. A person is eligible to return back home, back to Godhead, if he perfectly understands Krishna, his appearance and disappearance. This is verified by Krishna himself in Bhagavad Gita. Taktva deham puna janma naiti, mahameti sorjan, like that he says. That's what Prabhupada concludes here, saying that one has to learn about Krishna from Srimad Bhagavatam and the Bhagavad Gita. And that to do so, one has to follow in the footsteps of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Those who do not follow Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu cannot understand Bhagavad Gita and Bhagavatam. So to precisely put it, we can say that one has to search for Krishna in these two literatures, Gita and Bhagavatam. But how? By taking, following in the footsteps of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. If somebody says, I don't know Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and I am directly reading Bhagavad Gita, Bhagavatam, then you cannot understand Krishna. That's what Prabhupada says. Puna sanatana kahe yudi jui kare.
Puna sanatana kahe yudi jui kare.
Prabhu agnya dila vaishnava smriti kari bare.
Prabhu agnya dila vaishnava smriti kari bare.
So this we will do tomorrow from 3:24 onwards. Lord Chaitanya gives a synopsis of Vaishnava Smriti. This is the last part of this chapter and we will complete it in the next session. And we have done till now 3:23. Of this 24th chapter of the Madhya Lila. Thank you, Srila Prabhupada ki, aur Bhaktavinda ki, Jai.